Hello people, it's Blitz here. Welcome back to another episode of Rollercoaster Tycoon World. We had a slight problem with Windows. Windows decided to come up with a power fault and it just made my hard drives go nuts. One minute they were working, next minute they weren't working, then had probably network. It seems to be a known bug on the internet. Now I was hoping I might be able to get around it, but it wasn't going to happen, as even Microsoft's own technical service said the best way around it is reinstall Windows. So I had to reinstall Windows, and unfortunately I lost the folder which I had the video in. But I managed to get it off the server, and then we found another fault where update 6 somehow doesn't load an old update 5 file. But lucky for me, I actually had a recording which was saved with update 6. So we managed to carry on. Now the part might be a bit different slightly in a few areas from where we last finished, but not much, I can assure you. Now okay, this area, this end of the part is going to be sci-fi, and the other end I'm going to make western. And in the middle we're going to have obviously a bit of everything, and have a whimsy theme going all the way around it because it's new. We're just trying to see what happens. So as I said in the first video, because we've had so many problems playing this game, it's like, okay, still like a beta, things still work. Well, some things work, some things don't work, and the game crashes and God knows what. We're just going to see how many people we can get in here. If we get to about 2,500, 3,000 people, we'll make a proper park. But I'm not going to go down that route yet, because I've been down there so many times in the past, as you've seen of my videos, and we'll never finish the park because the game keeps going up the creek. So we got up to, I think we get up to about 1900 people by the end of this episode. So if we get to the next 1000, we will stop doing these videos, because we're only going to make 3, as I said. And we'll basically go back to making a proper park and see what we can do. So I'm now just putting in a couple of sci-fi rides. Nothing flash. As I said, I'm not doing anything flash at this time. I just want to see how far we can get within 3 videos. Get up to about 3,000 people. And I can say the game's working. I don't think we ever got the 3,000 people before, even though we had a wacky great big park. Let's see what works and what don't work. Now I have noticed, okay, the gates now work. People can't walk through the gates no more, but you have to give them about 60 seconds before they start working. The cleaners, they work, but they work a bit funny. They seem to clean up items 10 feet away. Well, it still works, but they're not in the right location. So far the engineers are actually fixing up rides. My roller coasters so far haven't broken. If you remember previously, I think we got to update 3 last time, or update 4, can't remember exactly, but people used to stop getting on the rides, regardless what you've done with them. I mean, sometimes you can pick the ride up, put it back down, and it start working again. We've not had that problem so far. They seem to be working, which is good. But there is one thing, all the roller coasters I ever used in the past, ones were made from scratch. I'm using ones built into the game now. So that bug could still be available. I don't know, you lot can tell me if you're actually playing a game. We might just do a quick test run at the end in part 3. We make a roller coaster and just see what happens after that. But if I remember rightly, when you got to about 1,500 people, 2,000 people, that's when the bugs started to go wrong, or come in, I should say, and break the park. Because it wasn't just the roller coaster that went wrong. You notice that people started leaving in droves. And when I mean in droves, I mean a whole of them all in one hit. Then they all suddenly come back again. Very bizarre. And you thought, okay, we get around that, reload the game. And then you find certain parts of your park stop working. And so far we haven't had those problems. So we just have to see what goes on. See if we it's all now working. I've not read no patch notes. Because I just, in the past, regardless of what they said in the patch notes, nothing ever worked. So I'm not going to bother going out. I'm just going to find out what works and what don't work as we play. So I'm just sticking in a lot of trees, a bit of foliage. I've added another toilet and another info centre. It's a pity they ain't changed the music in the game. It's unfortunately a bit boring. Could do some more soundtracks. And the other thing is, it would be nice if we could colour the rides. But I don't know, we're hoping. It's never going to be a Planet Coaster. Well, in some ways, that's a good thing, because we never really want two games to be the same. Similar, but not the same. Try and mix up the food. I wish these trees were bigger. These sci-fi trees, a bit more like picking flowers than trees. Which is actually, when you think about it, when you actually plant the other trees, they actually come out different sizes. And these sci-fi ones come out, well, I do if you do the conifers, these ones all come out the same size. So we want to keep people happy, have a mixture of themes, which some people don't like sci-fi, some people rather like adventure. We've got the Wincy, which I can't, one thing I don't understand, they've done the Wincy theme, but they only ever gave us one building for the haunted theme. So, well, why didn't you carry on with the haunted theme? He's like, you don't want to go that way, you want to do the Charles theme instead. I can't really understand that, because I think the haunted thing's been there from beta 1. So it's a bit bizarre where they decided to stop that altogether. I suppose there's something going on there, I don't know. Bizarre. No idea. So I just want to fill in this gap, put another child's ride in, keep the children happy. And we'll add some sci-fi elements to the game. Now I hate you when I do that, I put it on path in. Well, now I can change it afterwards, we can now anyway. So we're just going to carry on in this part here. I'm not sure how big the park will be, since we're not building no buildings. Obviously when you build buildings they take up a lot more space. Well, I do when I make them anyway. Now we're up Skelter. I do like the game, at the end of the day. It's only bad thing about it, it just don't work properly. Which has been like it for the last 12 months. But I suppose one day it'll get there. I'm hoping that will be 99.9% now fixed. So when we get to episode 3, it's all working lovely, and then we can finally build a park again. I won't go to it straight away, I will say. I should carry on with Planet Coaster. Finish off where, I can't remember how far I got in Planet Coaster. I got so busy over the winter period. I really can't think of what I was doing, what I wasn't doing. And the funny thing is, I was having a lot of fun making videos over the winter period, because obviously I want no gardening done. But then I got into a load of other stuff being fixed around the house. Doing a load of other parts for people around the area in their gardens when the sun turned up, which it wasn't that often. But now we're back. I can work out where I'm going and where I'm not going. Instead of being, okay, got a phone call, come sort this out. Now I know where I'm going now, I've got a worksheet back to normal. So I can now start making videos, try and get one out, two out every week. So I just want to make one of these locations, path locations, where you get your engineer or your cleaner, or any of the staff really, where they go. I think it's gone backwards since Rollercoaster Tycoon 3, where if I remember rightly, you can just say, right, you go here, there, and so and so. Because obviously we've got a big circle, goes over the grass, and it's like, well, what's going to go on the grass for? Nothing goes on the grass. And then I think it's a bit of a waste of, a lot of waste of space. So then we, okay, that's obviously the, can't go no more than that. And just get a person, find out why they ain't doing nothing, and drop me in the location. Get a spare one, because obviously they were all busy. Now I have noticed when you sometimes pick up a person and say, right, go there, on the cleaner that is, not that it's on any others, but on the cleaner, you drop him down and he just disappears, and you find out he's actually walking to the location from wherever. It's like, well, I thought the idea behind it was me to pick you up and drop you there so you get there extremely fast, not actually disappear, go back to where you was and start walking. Sometimes he does it, sometimes he don't, but it's definitely an engineer, a cleaner bug. So that's a sci-fi area. It's not too bad. Look, we've got a roller coaster, a swing, a spaceship thingy. Network scale. Quickly shoot to the other side. And we're going to do the western theme over here. See what we can come up with. I'm going to get roller coaster in, the wheel. Most of the stuff on the western theme anyway. So we get a path in. Otherwise we could be in sorts of trouble a bit later. And you notice that I'm actually using the full size path this time. They always used to complain that there's not enough space. So I just do what I usually do, figure out what rides I want. So we have the little wheel. Get your merry-go-round in now. Child's ride, family ride thing. What else can we get in here? Let's do a roller coaster. Get a wooden coaster. I've said the wooden coasters are a bit boring, but it goes with the western theme, so we've got to have one. So basically this is what we're going to use in this area. I do find in the past I get the rides I want, and I'll put them in the locations I want to put them in afterwards instead of, oh, I could have that and find out, oh, I ain't got enough room. Sort out all the spaces first. Get everything in the right location. Then we can sort out some other elements afterwards. So jump ahead a bit, we've added the paths to the rides, got the rides in the right spot. Just going to do a bit of terraforming, as I said in the past, I don't like anything being flat. Is that a bug? The ride obviously doesn't allow me to terraform a bit closer to the building. Don't remember having that before. But again, I might not terraform near it before. Yeah, flatten out and do it again. And get a bit of water element in there. Make it a little bit different. As the game got faster, the game has got faster. But according to my grunt card, it's not very well optimised because it gets a bit of a pasting. There's a long, long way to go. I don't have many patches they plan to release. When you think about it, we still don't have transport rides, and obviously if you've watched my videos before, we must have mentioned it god knows how many times. Obviously Atari don't stick to their own time schedule, their timeline, since they did say transport rides will come out on a game of release, and that was several months ago now, and we just got no transport rides. It's a pity really. Obviously the park itself gets quite big and it takes a long time for people to get A to B. But I suppose they must have a version of the game somewhere in their studio where, okay, adding transport rides must cause a lot of slowdown. That's what I reckon it is. I don't think it's down to obviously game crashing, I think it's down to game slowdown. I mean, what other improvements we got? We got obviously way better animation now. Animation on the people than we've ever had before. They do get better with every patch coming out. There is still faults where the bags are in a very odd location. Yeah, because I don't seem to have gravity in this game. They seem to go at funny angles, so I don't know why. Some walk very well, some don't walk very well. I mean, the funny thing is the cleaner, he seems to animate very well when he's walking, cleaning, God knows what. But the rest of the peeps seem to be a bit off. Let's go and get some trees in, like the old conifers. Bang them out all over the place. So I'm not doing anything flash, not just working out. Well, I usually do try and work. Okay, I'm gonna do a location here. Build the land up, have this on a high, this one on a low. I'm not doing anything like that. So I'm not gonna spend an hour just creating one ride to find out 24 hours later it don't work. So we're just doing, as I said, test run. See if the game falls apart. And if it don't, we obviously we make a new park. I see they've added the Asia piece by piece set. That would be nice if they added, I suppose, a few buildings to go with it. I might make one just for the head of it. Not done an Asia one. Might do that with a roller coaster. As I said, in the past we had the problem with a roller coaster, especially if you made one. So I thought, okay, we'll make an Asia building. Part 3. Bit of a roller coaster and just see what happens. It crashes, it crashes. At least we know at the end of the day. Put a mine in, just for the hell of it, take up some space. It's slightly over the path, but that'll do. Probably got anything flash, not now. It's not looking too bad now. Get the people on the rides. Go from there. Well, let's check out the roller coaster. See if it's any good. Well, that weren't too bad. I have to say, it's been a long time since I've been on a wooden coaster. I mean, the best thing about them is the sound. I think that's the part that scares you. All the creaking, sounds like it's falling apart. Let's get a few more elements in. Some sound, some lights. Otherwise I start complaining it's too dark. I don't always do. So far so good. Game ain't crashed, which is good. I think that's probably the first time I've actually played a game that ain't crashed one way or the other. Now I've said that, it probably crashed all the time. You know, it's got a bit of a gap there on the frame. That will appear once I reload the game. I decided to put a big rock at the bottom. Those ones on the right hand side of the path. Should remove the framework. I thought, oh, don't like that. I'll put on the other side of the path, but the frame on the coaster never reappeared. But you can get around it, just reload the game, it comes back. I suppose you could call that a bug in some aspect, I suppose. Seems to be quite quiet. Turned all the music on. It's a bit lousy. Unfortunately, these rocks don't really go with this terrain. But that's life. It's the Western thing. Now, so you see that big gap I've got there in a frame? Now if it does happen when I reload the game, if it's there, I'll definitely say it's a bug. There's one thing about this game, I've got HDR turned off. So it's buggy. I've reinstalled my PC since then. In the last video, I should turn it back on. See if it's got the same problem. But the lighting effect never seems to make the game stand out. Well, it looks so bad now. See the animation on the peeps. Some of them seem okay, some of them a bit odd. Look too stiff. Like robots. So moving on, I've actually gone back to the haunted house. I didn't notice after Windows crash. I never completed this part. So I've gone back to it and added the mist and the smoke effect. Small pumpkins. I think I'm missing some statues. I can't remember where I saw the statues. I know there's statues in the game. And if I was doing it properly, I'd have the fence and everything going around it as well. But we ain't gonna do that. Not on this stage anyway. If you look there, it don't look too bad, but the further you zoom out, the lighting effects, I don't stand out. The game actually looks quite flat and boring. The shadows that don't stand out enough. It's a pity, really. But that's the way it is. Well, let's get on this roller coaster. I can't remember if we've actually been on it. This is the rerun. But let's have a go. And then we'll finish up this episode. Well, that weren't too bad. Okay, I'm going to leave it there, and I'll see you in part 3. Blitz out. That is all.